In Koha, we are going to discuss about the serial control module. So to start with the serial control module, you have to first log in with user ID and password of Koha. And when you get this page, the main interface page of the Koha, then you click on serials. It will take you inside the serial where you have to manage the serial control, serial subscription. So here you can find the first thing, you have to search this subscription to proceed with this subscription of the serial. So if you want, you are going for the new subscription, then you simply click here new subscription, and it will open one form where you have to provide all the subscription detail. So in the subscription detail, the first option is to whom you are going to place the order. So in that case, you need to search the vendor, which you can do by clicking on this option. For example, you are going to place the order to Tata, then you click on OK. It will fetch the record from the vendor list and you select it. So you will observe that when you search and select the particular vendor, it will fetch the record and display the information here. Now the next option is, you have to search for the Biblio. There are two things. If the Biblio is already available in the database, you can search and select the Biblio and proceed with the subscription. Or if you do not have the Biblio in the database, in that case you can create the Biblio and proceed accordingly. So first thing, we will search for the Biblio. Just click here and enter the value which you are going to search and press enter. So we can see it has found four records related to our term. So in my case, I am going to select the journal of science. I'll take this, I'll choose it. So you can observe the information about that journal also has been displayed here. Now these are the two options given here. You can create the item record when receiving this serial, or you can create the item record, do not create an item record when receiving this serial. Two options are there. So accordingly you can create or do not create. When there is an irregular issue, for example, when you are, so you have subscribed, so if there is an an irregular issue, what you would like to do, whether you want to skip issue number or you want to keep issue number. So accordingly you can select the option. Now moving to the next option, that is the manual history. You can keep the manual history by checking this option. Then call number of for this particular serial which you have selected, library, which library you are going to select, then public note and non-public note, both options are there. You can enter the text for the public note, and if you want for the non-public note, then you can enter the text here. Then next option is patron notification, routing list. This will be discussing about the routing list in detail later. Selecting a notice will allow patron to subscribe to notification when a new issue is received. So this will provide the information about the routing list, through routing list patron notification. So next option is where the location of this journal. The definitely it will be in periodical section. Okay, how many days you want to give as a grace period? For example, I'll give 15 days. Number of issue to display to staff. How many issue you want to be displayed to staff? I'll take 12. And how many issue you want to display to the public at a time? For example, 4. So the first page of two temp means pages we have filled successfully, and just click on next. So it has taken us to the next form where we have to provide the serials planning, where we have to give the all frequency and subscription, when it starts and all the other details. So you will observe that the here it is asking the date for publication of the first issue. Let me take this 1st January 2014. What will be the frequency? Let us take it as a one issue per month. It means monthly. Then what will be the subscription length? How many issues you will be receiving? Enter amount in numerals. Just click 12 because it is monthly. When the subscription starts date, you have to provide the date for the starting the subscription. I'll take from January. Let us take 1st January. And when it ends, definitely it will be in the month of December 1st. Then what will be the numbering pattern? Numbering, you want volume number, issue, or only volume and number, or seasonal, or number only, or non-rollover, whatever you want, you can enter the detail. Definitely we would like to take as a volume and number. So as soon as you select this numbering pattern, it will bring down one small window where you can find the volume and number detail. If you want, you can enter the value here, or if you want the advanced pattern system, so you can use this option. So it will show you the pattern system in detail, where you can give the value, and accordingly you can test prediction pattern how it will be displayed. So you can see here all the information are correct, except the volume number we are not getting correctly, so we will modify the record here. You have option that you can modify the pattern. In this case, you can modify how you can change here. So you can see the pattern, we can change the information accordingly. So I have given in volume number, which should begin with volume 1, the number of the volume, and it should begin with the number of the particular volume. Then add number 1, and then every how many volume, 12 or whatever the information you want to give. Likewise, and finally you give the pattern name here and save as a new pattern. So you can see, and then test prediction pattern. So right side you will get the information about the pattern and the publication, means with the number and publication date. So in this way, prediction pattern you can see by selecting the different pattern given in the database, or you can create your own using these options. So we have given the prediction, or we have selected the pattern for numbering, and now we will move to the next option and we will finally save it. So the data about this issue is saved successfully. Now it's the time to receive the subscription. When you have finished the subscription, definitely you would like to receive the subscription, means issue now. So you have to enter the detail, or you have to receive the issues of the particular volume of particular journal, as in when you receive the issues. So for that, you suppose one issues after placing order, so it comes to library. So how will you receive that? First you need to search the particular journal you have placed the order. So it will fetch the record from the database, and it will show the serial subscription, one detail found. So you can just bring the right side it. So you will find here the title of the particular journal is given with all the detail, and expiry date also is given here. Right side it is given the issue history and serial received. you have to receive the serial by clicking this option. You just click this option, so it will take you to the pattern which you have selected, and it will display the window accordingly. You can see it is numbered volume 1, number 1. The publication date is on 1st January 2014, and it was expected to be received in the library on 1st January 2014. So what is the status? It is expected. Now it has come to library. So what you will do? You just select the arrived. So it means it has reached to the library, and save it. So you can see it has automatically generated the next expected issue date and the status expected, next issue number 2, and when you are going to receive, it is expected. Now you have not received. So after 1 month, for example, after 1 month the second issue does not come, after 1 month again the third issue comes. So what you will do in that case? First you have to search it will display the same record what we saw in the previous window. Just go to signal serial receive. It will display the pattern system, and it has not means the second number of the volume 1 is expected. So you can set it as a late. It means the second volume, second number of that particular volume of the journal has not come, and the third month it has come. So you can save it. So that particular issue will be treated as a late issue. So later when it comes, you can receive it manually, and it is showing third is expected. You just click on edit serial, and you can receive the third issue of the particular journal and save it. So automatically it will generate the expected date of the fourth issue of the journal. You can observe here the second one is still status is late. Now for example, 1 month definitely you would like to generate the claim. Why? Because the journal has not come and it is fourth month now. So first you need to do, go to serial control, you first search for the journal, just click enter, you will be taken to the particular serial, and from here you can generate the claim. Left side you can see there is an option claims. So you have to select the vendor with whom you have placed the order, and just click OK. So you can see already it has fetched the record. The vendor is Tata McGraw-Hill Library, and which journal, which issue of which volume, what is the status, and since when it is the issue is not received by the library. So you can select the particular issue or the particular field, and you can select the option here, send notification. You just click on send notification, so automatically it will send the notification to the particular vendor. So one means you can find here, earlier it was coming status late, now the information is coming that it is claimed, and on which day you claimed for that particular issue, the date will be displayed here. So we have successfully claimed for the particular issue which is not received by the library. Now moving to the next option, first search for the journal and go to serial receive. For example, the volume 2 has been claimed. Now you can, when it comes in the fourth month, you can go to the status and you can Means both the suppose both the issues, volume number 4 and number 2 received by the library, so you receive manually in the system also. So both the issues will be received in the system also, and you will not find the status of the second issue of the volume 1 as a late. So you have received the serial, the issue of the particular journal successfully in the library, and it will display the number of next number of the volume and status here. You can edit this, and again you can go for the means receiving. So receive one by one whenever it is received by the library. So in this way we can receive the issues in the system. Now the next option, for example, this particular issue of this volume of this journal is missing. So how will we can set the status missing? Select the particular issue, go to edit serial, and here there is an option missing. You can select this option and click on save. So that particular issue will be status will be missing, and you receive all the means issues, save it. After 1 month you find that the missing issues you found in the library, so you can again set the status of the particular issue, whatever the status is, you can set accordingly. So you can see the again the issue which was missing, the status is showing here, arrived. Now receive all the serial issues. Okay, so here just I'll go back. You can see we have received all the issues successfully. Now I would like to show you how it is displayed in the OPAC. For example, after receiving all the issues of this particular journal, you just open the OPAC and just search for the journal. So you will find here the journal which you have received, Journal of Science. It will show all the detail here, it holding journal serial, location where it is kept, reference, it is not for the loan, and if you click subscriptions, it will display the information about your subscription. You can see here volume 1, number 1, volume 2, likewise it is displaying the information about this particular journal. If you want to see the full history, it will display the information in this way. So we can see that it is showing the detail for the year 2014. If you want to see the normal view, you can go back to the normal view. It will display the information as it was displaying in the first time when you entered the detail. So likewise we can see the subscription detail in the OPAC as well. So this was all about how you can place the how you can subscribe new journal through serial module in Koha. The next option in this, after receiving all the issues, definitely the expiry means subscription will expire. So in that case the system will automatically display the information about renew. So that you can do by clicking on renew, and you can simply submit it. So it will again generate the, now you can see here it will renew the item and it will allow you to receive the 12th issue of that particular serial journal. So you will receive all the journals in that particular 2014. You see all the journals of issues of that particular journals are received, volume 1, number 1 to 12. And in 2015 it has generated the new pattern numbering means pattern for this particular journal. So we can renew for the particular journal with the system in such a way, and it will automatically generate the pattern system also. So we have seen that how we can do the how we can subscribe new journal using the serial control in Koha.